Across from, we passed the Witches Museum to get in, and then we stood across from the entrance to the Psychic Fair, am I right? Is that where we were? The Witch City Mall, which was like the epicenter of everything weird. There are some sights and sounds up there, boy. But how many of you know that the heart of God was right in the middle of that place? We didn't do anything crazy up there. But what was obvious is God wanted to show us something, and he showed us two different spectrums of who he is. See, we were meeting up with a team that was up there, and we were trying to find them. So I got in touch with them on the way up there, and we were trying to find them where they were. But there was thousands of people there. So as we walked behind the Witch City Mall, we came to an area where the street was blocked off, and there were booths set up with different psychics and different witch stuff and all kinds of stuff like that. And we took a left at that area just to see if we could figure out where they were. So we walked through hundreds of people or whatever it was, looking for people that were dressed up as monks, witches, and prisoners. Monks, angels, and prisoners. That's what they were wearing. So we went amongst all the other costumes that were there. So as we went through this area, we came upon this small group of, I don't know how many guys it was, but it looked like a few guys, three or four or whatever it was, that were there, and one of them had one of those little pocket speakers with a microphone on it and was reading scripture off his phone. And the other guy stood there with a sign that elevated way above everybody, and it was scriptures, and they were just calling fire down on people, telling them that they're deceived. And you know, they weren't, I never heard anybody say you're gonna go to hell for this. I don't know if it was said or not, but the feel coming off of them was almost worse than you could feel. Now, hear me now. I'm not typically a feeler, or haven't been to this point, but my head was closing. I mean, you can ask the people I was with. I felt it was just pressure. So they stood there yelling out their scriptures, holding up their signs, arguing with people. We passed one guy. Were you with me when we passed that one guy that was screaming and yelling about how God and blah, 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 after he had just come away from those people? So we got down to the end, and we hadn't found the group that we were looking for. So we turned around and headed back through that area and got back to the center again, and then continued down the other way to where it was the entrance to the psychic fair. Now, this group, it's probably their sixth year. Justin was here last November, and he showed the video called Witch City, which was this group in Salem ministering to people. Now, what they used to do is they would go into the psychic fair, and they would rent a booth, set up a booth in the psychic fair, and they'd give away free spiritual readings. Now, that was how they would typically do this. And people would come up and, well, everybody else is charging money, you guys are free, so they would go there. The psychic community got together this past year and went to the mayor of Salem and said, you have to stop this because they're taking all of our business. So the words that were given prophetically through this group were much more accurate and effective than any of the psychics that were there, to the point that they got together and petitioned the mayor to get rid of this group. So the minister that was there, the minister that's there all the time, he agreed. He doesn't want to be at odds with the city. He said, we won't set up the booth. So they didn't set up the booth. So instead, what they did is they went dressed as monks, angels, and prisoners with signs that said free spiritual encounters, free spiritual readings. There was one of them's son, 5-year-old boy, stood there with a cloak on that said, tell me a joke and then let me hug you.
But the sign behind
and
him
then
said...
And then when he turned around, he had a sign on his back that said, "You're amazing."
And that kid was working the crowd, man. People were telling jokes. He was hugging. If they walked away without hugging him, he would be like, "Where's my hug?" And he would say, "God bless you." And it was great.
So to watch this group, now you how many of you you've heard me say, if you're willing to look like an idiot, he'll make you look like a genius. Well, that was on display. And watching people get wrecked and healed and everything else, hearing testimonies of stuff that's going on, and you know, woman's walking with Cain and with 10 other people, and they're self-proclaimed atheists. And we met with DJ up there, and DJ says, "I had all the atheists put their hands on her, and I stood back, and I had them pray, and she gets healed in front of all of the atheists." You know what I mean? It's coming to Fall River. Yeah. So we didn't actually participate in anything crazy. We got there at the end of the day when they were kind of exhausted. We gave out a few words. We talked a few words. Robin got a word. You know, and the other Robin got a word. Both Robins got words while we were up there. But anyway, it's exciting. So we definitely got some training and equipping while we were up there. But God is in the middle of darkness. You know where we parked? And we realized it later. Where did we park? Beacon Street. Come on. That's cool. Yeah. So it's going to get crazy up in here. I'm just warning you now. You know? It's good stuff. Get excited, because I am calling this Vision Sunday. If you were here a few weeks ago, you heard Pastor Steve kind of give me a word about getting the vision out there, publishing it, that kind of stuff. I have felt that I need to speak it publicly before the church. Yes, a lot of you have heard pieces of it, but you haven't heard the depths of it as to what I have, what Lisa and I feel that God wants to do here at the Porch. I am going to roll all of it out today. But understand that God is still carving into it. But I'm going to roll all of it out today. Oh, come on. Get a little happy about it. Jeez. Good Lord. I feel like a cheerleader up here sometimes. You know what I mean? Were you all at the Salem thing last night too? No? All right. I don't know. I wanted Doritos when I left. Yeah. So, Father, we love you, God. We thank you, God, for your grace. Won't you stand right where you are? Father, we just give you glory and honor and praise, God. Father, we're here for an encounter with you this morning, God. We don't want anything else but the reality of who you are, God, to be magnified in this place, God. So, Father, I speak right now against fear and doubt and worry and shame and all that stuff that would come on people in this room. And we say, get off right now. We proclaim freedom in this place right now, God. Freedom in this place, God. Freedom. Holy Spirit, have your way. Do whatever it is that you want to do. God, we are declaring a new beginning today, God. A complete new beginning, God. Father, where even relationships will be restored. Hearts will be restored. Finances will be restored. The devil will be broken and strapped down to the ground, where we'll step on him every time we walk through. And it's in Jesus' name, Father. In Jesus' name, we worship you, God. We love you. Just put his name on your lips. Father, we thank you, God, for your grace, God. We thank you for your grace, God. We thank you for your heart for us, God. We thank you that you are a good Father. We thank you that regardless of what we've done all week long, God, you are still here saying, "Come to me, my son, I will make you free." Jesus, Jesus.
Thank you.
It's your kindness that draws me closer to the river where my soul is satisfied. I am surrounded when I surrender. In your presence, I know I don't have to hide. For it's your kindness that draws me closer to the river where my soul is satisfied. And I am surrounded when I surrender. In your presence, I know I don't have to hide. For it's your kindness that draws me closer to the river where my soul is satisfied. I am surrounded when I surrender. Streams of living water, your love that overflows. I find here in your presence all I need. Here I lay my life before you. I will give you everything.
Stay in this place. Stay here. How many of you have been feeling like God is calling you closer and calling you deeper? Is that a collective? If that is you, there is something about activating the call of God in your life. So if God is calling you to something deeper, it's up to you to step into the deeper that He's calling you. I'm going to ask you that if you feel that God is calling you deeper, here's a sentence that I've been hearing lately over and over and over. God just keeps saying it over and over and over. Fire falls on sacrifice. This is what surrender looks like. I'm going to ask you that if you feel that God is calling you to a deeper place and you want to activate that call in your life, you want to step into that, I'm going to ask you to prophetically take those steps. Come forward now. Thank you, Father. This is not a pressure thing. This has got to be the call of God in your heart to go deeper and to truly surrender to a deeper place. And what I'm going to ask is, Lisa is going to sing that part over you. And God is going to touch you in that moment. Like, I am not going to touch you. I honestly feel that I am not supposed to. This is something God wants to do on His own. I'm going to ask you, just listen, put your hands this way. Put your hands like this. Just in a position to receive what He's putting on you right now. Come on. Come on. Thank you, Father. Father, we're here giving you our complete surrender, God. Thank you.
It draws me closer. give it all up for him. He loves you so. He has great expectations. He has marked you with his mark of love, something that only you can impart to this world. And he wants you to step in and step out. Release what he has given you. Do not let anything hold you back. This is your ground. It's yours to take. I am saying, Father, right now, let your liquid love fall. Let them release what they have of you. Let nothing stop them. No bars held back. They are going forth. They are breaking through. Breakthrough, breakthrough, breakthrough. That is what I hear. Not just for each and every one of you. I believe as a community, as a church, breakthrough. You ain't seen nothing yet. Because when the fire of God comes and his love is poured out, it changes everything. Nothing is the same. And you carry that, guys. It's within you. Let it out. Give it up for him. This world needs you. This church needs you. This city needs you. The nations need you. You run, and run hard, and be relentless in love. Be relentless in your love. Father, give them your eyes to see, your heart to feel. Let them release what you have put in them before time. Thank you, Jesus, for all you do. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Fall fresh on us. We love you, we love you, we love you. We love you. Yes, stay there, stay there, stay there. Father, your hands, your work, let it just pour, 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 pour. Breakthrough, breakthrough. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. It's deeper than you think, guys.
Better. comes right. The precious blood of Christ, it's rewriting my history.
Person up here. And then when you raised up worship, it got stronger and song. He saw him up here singing with everyone in the room. Right? I'm going to tell you what. You want a touch from God, this little boy is going to touch you right now. You line up right here. And he's going to release the Holy Ghost on you right here. Come on, you.
destiny. It's rewriting my history. Covers me with destiny. It's making all things right. The precious blood of Christ. It's making all things right. The precious blood of Christ. It's rewriting my history. Covers me with destiny. Making all things right. The precious blood of Christ.
Father, thank you that through the mouths of babes, God, you'll take the foolish things to confound the wise. So, Father, we thank you for your grace in this place. We love you, God. We love you, God. We love you, Father. We love you, Father. We love you, Father.
Let me tell you, you are. Because when you step out in that faith, that will come back to you much more than you're giving out. And I'm talking about that from experience. Because I've had that come in and try to do that. And I've said, no, that's not how it works. So I just want to pray now that everybody here step out in that faith and know that God is not going to let you down, and he will bless you with abundance. More than you can ever imagine. In Jesus' name, amen.
it's hard to transition out of that. But to be honest with you, I don't think we're supposed to. But what he wants me to share this morning, and I know it, that I know it, that I know it, that I know it, is going to shape the history of who we are. I know we normally shake hands and stuff like that and kiss and hug, and I give Mike time to switch the thing over, but I'm not going to give him that tonight, so just go ahead and switch it. Because I feel like God wants to stay.